on a jack. When you coming back, where's you at on the mat? Everything is intact. Could have been a seamstress, still wouldn't cut him slack. Pretty much ain't got a clue. Itty bitty piggyback off everything I do. But I'm still dropping. Got him looking like James Harden at the awards. Back to you, I'm so into you. For real, real, like I'm keen to you. If you would add to you, they be mad when I tend to you. That's what the bay like. Call me Buffy, cause that's what I slay like. These, I sun them like it's daylight. These, wanna know what it's like. What it's like, yo, what it's like, yo. They wanna know what it's like, yo. All this ice is like snow. Get kimonos and let's fly to Tokyo. Pretty, pretty, please, baby, won't you cop this for me?
Hello, everybody. I'm Jonathan Coachman, and this is Super Bowl Sunday on EA Sports. Up next, we've got what ought to be a great matchup between the Oakland Raiders and the Carolina Panthers. Kickoff now just moments away. It is finally time to crown a champion, as I'll hand it over to the two men who will call the action, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Brandon Gunn, to my left is my good friend Charles Davis, and what a thrill to be here for the biggest one of them all, the Super Bowl. And it seems to get bigger every year. The lights get brighter, the cameras more numerous. I don't know, there's just so much that goes into this game. It's an honor to be here, isn't it?
It is an honor, and I can't wait to share this game with you. This is going to be a whole lot of fun. You're my partner, my best friend. I can't imagine being anywhere else but right here with you. And just think about it this way. You mentioned the magnitude. This is no longer just a game for America or even North America. This is worldwide. People watching from just about every country in the world. This is impressive.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and just about ready to roll. All the talk, all the hype, but the past is prologue as this Super Bowl is underway. On the return, it's Kenyon Barner. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Fake here on first down, buying time to his left, and he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Oh my Cam, there's times when I'm not analyzing up here, I'm just appreciating. Led NFL quarterbacks in rushing last year. He is truly the ultimate weapon at that position.
This is Newton off the play fake to McCaffrey. They're rolling out right. Flush to his right. Oh, and now he bowls him over. Breaks the tackle. Now an alley. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket. Got to the sticks and picked up the first down.
They go play action here on first down. His throw incomplete.
today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Second and 10, moving again. Cam fighting, he lost the football. It's Apple, messes him off.
On plays like this, where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Third and long, it's Newton. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line, Khalil Mack. Able to track him down for a loss of 13, and it'll bring up fourth down. They are going to go for it. It's Newton. And this is incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And now, boy, the ball's going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line.
I don't know why you would do that. It's almost guaranteed points the other way. I mean, I get it if it's a late game situation, maybe even fourth and inches. But boy, that's a huge risk to take.
Yeah, now they're set up in prime position going the other way. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. A chance for the first score of this Super Bowl. Here's first and goal. Working from the gun, it's Carr. The quick slant, caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. To open the scoring in Super Bowl 52. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. And on the grandest of stages, with the whole world watching the Super Bowl, they come out and get the first points.
I don't know how you feel about Brandon, but for me, watching the beginning of the Super Bowl, I've often wondered how come it's not just a fumble fest. How come the ball's not all over the place? The nerves, the interim in between of the 2 weeks waiting for the game. But this team came out and handled it just like it was a regular season walk in the park. Terrific start.
On for the extra point, Giorgio Tavecchio. Tavecchio good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. A nice, tidy little drive there, getting the ball in excellent field position, and only one play to score it. Tavecchio now to kick this one away. Now it's Barner. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Now a carry, and C.J. Anderson takes it to the 26, just a 1-yard gain. Here's Newton now on second down. And they've got the hookup. This is Olsen. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Now a play fake, and it's Newton. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And this may be a big early turning point in this Super Bowl. They're going to go for it on fourth down here. They will go for it. Now Newton. And it is incomplete. Rashawn Melvin that time able to make the play. So shall we say a bold decision to go for it, and that bold decision does not pay off.
And when you talk about bold, you're saying all caps?
All caps.
Yeah, without a doubt. Maybe they're telling their defense they have a lot of faith in them. I mean, that's how you have to spin it, is that you tell your defense, you know something? We were able to go for it there because you guys are so good. I'm not worried about things. That's the only explanation I can come up with in this situation.
Well, he better get ready to spin it for that post-game presser because you know he's going to be asked.
He's going to have to spin it for his own locker room, frankly.
For Marshawn Lynch. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
Now, that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job, and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receiver. Receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
On second down, here's Carr. And this is Carr. Touchdown, Raiders. Jordy Nelson, a 20-yard touchdown. And the Raiders add on to their lead.
It's never fun for a defense to run on the field knowing that they're having to defend a short field. Just the idea of trying to limit an offense in that position, daunting for a defense.
The lefty Tavecchio now to add the extra point. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And that'll make the score 14-0. They have the short field, and they made quick work of it. Just two plays to get into the end zone. Tavecchio now to kick this one away. Now it's Barner. Turn here, he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. On first and 10, Newton. This one complete to Devin Funchess. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Now Newton on first down. And Olsen over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. That one goes for 24 yards. Now a first down throw for Newton. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Play action, it's Newton. That is caught at the 7. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Devin Funchess, 36 yards. And the Panthers have got it back to a one-score game. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Graham Gano on for the extra point.
Delay of game, offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. Graham Gano on for the extra point. Gano the extra point, and that'll make our score 14-7. A drive there of just 4 plays, and Carolina scores to cap it off. Gano out to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. The Raiders offense now making their way back out onto the field.
Now right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Don't forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Back to the ground, this time Lynch. Shaq Thompson on the tackle that time.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive.
Throwing his car on third down. It's caught, Nelson. So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. 14-7 is the score. The NFL on EA Sports continues right after this message.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis. It's the Raiders in possession of the football. And they've got it here with a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 11 more on that one and another first down. What makes a draw play like that successful?
Well, we did see where he made the first wave miss, and that was a big part of it. But a lot of it is just being actors back there, making the defense think it's going to be a pass.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
So 5 yards there as one of the big guys up front moved.
And in a 4-3 front, you've got the two defensive tackles right near the football. I know there's a lot of movement around there, but they're always taught to have one eye on the football. Apparently, that didn't happen.
Following the penalty, Lynch. And he'll be stopped up quickly here at the 38. Just a yard on the pickup there. It'll be second and four.
felt me get a little jangly up there before that last play call. And then once it happened, I was like, oh, because it feels like almost a missed golden opportunity to take a shot in that position.
You think first and five, maybe you go for a little more than a short run?
Almost a free down.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Second down, Lynch. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. Now, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
From the gun now on third down, Carr. And this is going to be incomplete.
And I feel like my man Old Mo, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a three and out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. This will be from 56 yards out. And this one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
So the missed 56-yarder, and now the flip side. Good starting field position at the 46 near midfield. He's going to go deep for Funchess. It's caught at the 10. Touchdown, Carolina. Devin Funchess, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Gano now to add the extra point. Extra point try good by Gano. And we've got a tie game here in a back and forth first half. And they're able to get the connection on the long touchdown pass. And that's one of the easiest drive summaries you'll ever see. One play, touchdown. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it. And they'll take it out to the 25. Amari Cooper and the rest of the offense heading back out there now. And you look at the numbers, not only has he not caught a pass, they haven't targeted him yet. And we're coming up toward halftime.
And you remember our meeting with the coach beforehand? What did he tell us about him? I write his number on my play sheet, and I circle it in bold, bold type because I want to make sure he gets the ball and often.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Carr to throw after the play fake to Lynch.
And he will not get away from the pressure here. Carr taken down. Mario Addison. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DM.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Second down. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line.
Well, that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, we have to keep getting in his face. Now let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey. After the sack, they'll come up now, 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We'll come back to Super Bowl 52 after this.
Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a 3rd and long. And indeed, that's what they'll do as they run it here. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. A pretty good effort there, 9 yards, but not enough. We'll likely see the punt team now on 4th down. Well, they did go run, so you were right. Maybe a little more breathing room for 4th down.
No one wants to be accused of playing it safe, right? But instead, they would just reverse it and say, we're playing it smart.
So on 4th down, here's Johnny Townsend to punt it. Christian McCaffrey deep for Carolina. This is brought in at the 21. Well, nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
They fake the give. Newton. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Tahir Wagner. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
The Raiders offense now, they trot back out.
They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they.
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe.
The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. From midfield, here's Carr. Over the middle, it's Jared Cook. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. Shotgun now for Carr. And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Panthers. The 30. Past the 20. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. And what we just saw, very, very rare. We only had five of those in the first 50 Super Bowls.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and we just saw it happen again. Extraordinary.
The defense has been good, and they were good again there. Gano for the extra point. Gano the extra point. And the lead is now 21-14. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way. The fumble return for a touchdown. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. That'll be taken in the end zone. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. The Panthers defense, they make their way back out there now. And now here come the Raiders. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just...
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Shaq Thompson, tough to handle on that blitz. He gets him for a loss of five.
Man, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit up with a screen soon.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. So we've come upon halftime in the big one, the Super Bowl. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight. As we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. It's been a tremendous season of football, but it's not over yet. One half remains to decide who will stand on the podium with the Vince Lombardi Trophy. And to call the second half, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. That's fielded in the end zone. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it. And they'll take it out to the 25. Out comes the Raiders offense. They'll go on offense first to start quarter number three. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked
to him. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Mario Addison. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of nine.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. Five sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Right. Now Carr throwing on second down. And complete right side to Cook. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
The Raiders on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 11. From the gun, it's Carr. And that is incomplete.
Well, partner, anytime someone tells me that fundamentals are leaving the game, I'm going to show them this play because they couldn't get to the passer. So what do you have to do? Get your hands up in the passing lane, and they batted it away on a third down attempt.
Here now, Johnny Townsend on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This is taken around the 12. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part,
he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. To throw on second down is Newton. Caught left side by Funchess. And he's brought down after a good gain. A really good pickup of 28 yards. And now they're in the hurry up. Now a play fake here on first down. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 42-yard line. They go play action here on first down. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. A gain of 32 that time. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey, and they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
The best thing that ever happened to Mario Edwards Jr., in my estimation, was moving from defensive end into defensive tackle.
Why is that?
I think he had such good size, but his quickness now is overwhelming when he works inside against guards and centers. And that allows him to make plays as one we just saw there, getting into the backfield and getting a tackle for the loss.
Here's Newton. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
I like the play call. Go to the play action, see if you can sneak your tight end out there and find him open in the end zone.
And just defensively, they weren't fooled and able to bat it away. Fourth down, and here's Graham Gano now in the field goal unit for the Panthers. And now before they run this fourth down play, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down. They snap it to Newton. And that'll be caught. Touchdown, Panthers. Olsen. Greg Olsen
from 10 yards out, and the Panthers add on to their lead.
A good, sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice two-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
Gano now to add the extra point. And he pushed it right. It's no good. Gano out to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now the Raiders offense, they get set to head back on the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?